guys, welcome back to Prospect Channel TV. Thank you for always coming out here. May God bless you all. Nnamdi Kanu speaks on attacks and killings in the southeast region. There has been deadly attacks in the southeast region lately, and these have got so many people talking. Nnamdi Kanu, the leader of the indigenous people of Biafra, has accused those delaying an appeal against him at the Supreme Court of being responsible for the rising insecurity in the southeast region. Ifani Ejiofor, the lead counsel for IPOB, said on Tuesday. The lawyer in a Facebook post said, Mr. Kanu stated this when he, Ejiofor, and other members of Mr. Kanu's legal team visited the IPOB leader at the facility of the State Security Service, SSS, on Monday in Abuja. Mr. Kanu, who is facing a terrorism trial, was granted bail in April 2017. He left the country after an invasion of his home in Afaruku near Umuahia, Abia State, by the Nigerian military in September 2017. He was adopted in Kenya and brought back to Nigeria in June 2021, about 4 years. After he fled the country, the Court of Appeal Abuja on the 13th October held that the IPOB leader was extraordinarily renditioned to Nigeria and that the action was a flagrant violation of the country's extradition treaty and also a breach of his fundamental human rights. The court therefore struck out the terrorism charges filed against Mr. Kanu by the Nigerian government and ordered his release from the custody of the DSS. But the government refused to release the IPOB leader, insisting that he, Kanu, could be unavailable in subsequent court proceedings if released and that his release will cause insecurity in the southeast. The government, through the Office of the Attorney General of the Federation, appealed the court ruling and subsequently obtained an order from the Supreme Court staying the execution of the Court of Appeal judgment freeing Mr. Kanu. Mr. Ejiofor said the government has practically abandoned the appeal by their deliberate refusal to file another court process in prosecuting the appeal, which it filed against the judgment of the Court of Appeal freeing the IPOB leader. The lawyer said Mr. Kanu, whom he calls Onyendo, directed him to inform the world that the government, which has delayed the hearing of the appeal against the IPOB leader, was behind the attacks and killings in the southeast. There is the need to let the world know, as directed by Onyendo, that those presently responsible for the delay in assigning a date for the speedy hearing of the appeal before the appeals court are the same people or institution who are relentlessly finding funding the criminal activities of the soulless elements who are fully paid to destroy our sacred land, he said, without giving any evidence. Otherwise, the expeditions hearing of this appeal will determine the release / freedom of Onyendo and will leave the criminal element with no other option than to immediately vacate or desert our land, Mr. Ejiofor stated. He said the IPOB leader also asked everyone, particularly government of other countries and institutions, to prevail on the Nigerian judiciary to assign a date for the hearing of the appeal. Mr. Kanu faulted the Court of Appeal for expeditiously granting the government's application for a stay of the execution of its judgment, which freed him. He said the IPOB leader have condemned the recent attacks and killings in the southeast during a controversial 5-day sit at home in the region, saying those behind the declaration and enforcement of the civil order were criminals and known enemies of our land. Simeon Ekpa, a controversial Biafra agitator and leader of the pro-Biafran group Autopilot, IPOP, a faction of the IPOP, declared his seat at home via his verified Twitter handle on 7th December. Mr. Ekpa, who resides in Finland, and warned residents of the region to stay indoors throughout the 5 days or have themselves to be blamed if they disobey the order. Premier Times reported how gunmen said to be enforcing the controversial sit-at-home order in the region killed some residents, including a police officer in Imo and Enugu states, between Friday and Saturday. Mr. Kanu deeply commiserates with those who lost their lives and properties during the attack, Mr. Ejiofor said. He, however, appreciated his followers for obeying his directive to ignore the sit-at-home order. He asked residents of the region to monitor and fish out from their hideout the gunmen enforcing the order in the region. So guys, what's your take concerning this? Nnamdi Kanu have said that those who are responsible on the attacks, killings in the Southeast region are the same people who are delaying an appeal against him at the Supreme Court. He said they are the people responsible for the rising insecurity in the Southeast region. And if you tell me, I go say that yes. If you ask me now, I will say yes. The federal governments are responsible because they know that releasing Nnamdi Kanu will end all the problems in the Southeast. You understand? But they have refused to do that. I'm dropping.